In this section, we're going to discuss the different types of purchase documents. So you have three kind of key purchase documents in the system on the ordering side. So you have a blanket order, you have a purchase quote, and you have a purchase order. So a blanket order is designed to be a contract between your company and a vendor. Typically, it's so you can get volume discounts. You're agreeing to buy maybe a larger quantity over a set period of time so that you can get a reduced price. You don't necessarily know when you want that to be delivered to you. So you're just going to create purchase order releases when you actually want that vendor to ship you the product. So again, this is really beneficial for the vendor because they can get a bit of a sense of what they're going to need to supply to you over a set period of time. And it's beneficial for you because again, you can negotiate typically better pricing because you're agreeing to buy more product. Blanket orders will track how much has been released off their blanket order. So a business can decide once you've hit the blanket order quantity amount, do you need to go back, create a new purchase order, renegotiate the pricing, or could you just increase? But the nice thing is that if your blanket order is for 10,000 and you release over multiple purchase order releases, you hit that 10,000 quantity, the system will let you know, oh, by the way, you've consumed this blanket. Again, different options in terms of what you can do, but all of that tracking is under that blanket purchase order. You'd be able to see what's been posted against it, what purchase orders are open against it, and there's that link and connection. So inside of Business Central, we see here that we've got our landing page. I can always search for blanket purchase orders. This would bring me to a list of all of the blanket purchase orders that are created inside of our system. And we can open it up and take a look. So here I've got a blanket purchase order. The thing I really love about purchase documents and sales documents in BC is that when you learn one card record, it really becomes easy to apply that knowledge to different areas of the system. So everything that we learn on a blanket purchase order could easily be applied to a purchase quote or a purchase order. So I'll just go ahead and open up my general section. So I've got the vendor number. So that's the supplier that I'm working with. I can type in their vendor number. I could also just start keying in their name and the system would be smart enough to find that purchase document. The vendor name will populate with the address information from the vendor card as soon as I select that vendor number. I can see the document date. So this is the date that I'm creating the document inside of my ERP system. The due date here is going to actually be based on my posting date. If I were to post the purchase invoice today, when would I be required to pay that vendor? This can be a bit of a funny feel to have on a blanket purchase order. So I would probably hide that. On this page, it becomes a lot more applicable to a financial person, maybe on something like a purchase order. So next we have order date. So again, not as applicable on a blanket purchase order. That's when you're actually going to place a purchase order. So when you take a blanket purchase order and you want to do a release and make that an actual firm purchase order so that the vendor can deliver, the order date is what you will populate prior to your make order function, which we'll look at in a moment. Vendor shipment number, again, is something that's more applicable for the actual receiving side, so we'll skip over that for now. You can indicate order address codes, so if you've got a vendor with multiple locations, you would be able to indicate those different order addresses and then select them from a list and display those. Again, more applicable during the order entry phase, which we'll see, but if your vendor has their own reference for the blanket purchase order in their system, you can use the vendor order number field to have that reference inside of Business Central. You've got a purchaser code field, so this would allow you to be able to indicate who the buyer is or who the person responsible is for this blanket PO. Down below, you'll see information has populated again from the vendor card. So you're able to see the currency based on the values that you see. Is this, you know, Canadian, US? Of course, blank is your local currency, and then any other currency code would be indicated in the field. You've got payment terms for this blanket PO that would default into any purchase order releases. You can change these in those individual purchase releases if you need to or want to. This is just the master setup for the blanket agreement. You can indicate with tax liable whether or not taxes should be calculated for the supplier. Tax area code would indicate which percentage to use based on your tax setup. You can associate dimensions to a blanket purchase order. You've got a location code, meaning when you do the blanket releases, when you create the purchase order and you do the receipt, which location is going to increase. Shipment method being how you're typically going to ship, or the vendor's going to ship to you. So you can see here a list. This is the predefined Microsoft list. Whenever you see new and select from full list, this means that you would have the ability to be able to determine what is in that list. So you can remove any shipment methods that aren't applicable to you. You can add any that aren't there. You would do so by just clicking on new. You would enter in a unique identifier or a code for that shipment method. And then you can enter a description that's usually a little bit more user-friendly and has more characters. So that logic applies for all of the different fields. And then down below, you've got your shipping and payment. So right now it's indicating that I'm going to pay Nod Publishers. If I wanted, I could select another vendor who maybe is their parent company. That's who I will pay when I actually do purchase releases. That would be the balance on that vendor account. So again, that's just the header information of a blanket purchase order. Then you've got your line information. So as we can see here, on a blanket purchase order, you can expense directly to a GL. So that's common for things that are, you know, special tools, special buys. You don't really need to create an item for them. You've got items which would exist in your item list. They could be a regular inventory item. They could be a non-inventory item, but they will have an item master record. You could purchase a resource, which is very common for things like services, or if you're paying for any kind of like labor. You can buy fixed assets and you can associate charge items. So charge items would give you the ability to be able to assign cost from a specific type of charge into the item to increase the cost of that item. So we'll run through our fields here. So because I've selected type, when I drop down number, I'm presented with a list of my items. If I had selected GL account, it would have dropped down to a look at my chart of accounts. So your number is going to be, in this case, the item that I want to purchase. You have an item reference field. So this would be if the vendor has their own part ID for this item. You could have your internal company item number. You could also reference what the vendor calls it, which is very common to put on the PO, because a lot of the times vendors don't care what you call it, they care what they call it. So this gives you that ability on the item master record to set that up if you need to. You've got a description that has pulled in again from my master record. I can see the location code. So when I create a purchase order release, this location code will default into that purchase order. I can again change it on that specific purchase order if it applies and I need to. I have my quantity. So this is the blanket order quantity. This is the agreement that we've come to. So over the course of some period of time, I am agreeing to buy 750 of my desk and 3,000 chairs. I can see the unit of measure. So when I drop down this list, you would be able to see that this will only display for me any units of measure that have been associated to that item. So Business Central allows you to be able to have multiple units. So I can stock my chairs in a piece. I could purchase them or sell them in a set. The system now knows that when I buy, sell, etc. in a set, I would be buying 4 pieces. So that conversion is always there and I can now use both of those units however I need to. So I've got the direct unit cost, so that defaults in off of my item card. But again, if I have negotiated better pricing because I am buying so many over the course of my blanket period, I can always change this unit cost to reflect what that agreement was. I've got a tax area code, so this is where I would indicate. It should default in from the header, but I could indicate on the line which area code calculates my taxes. So now I can see below, I've got my total excluding my taxes because I've indicated on the line that this is a taxable item and which area to use. I've got my tax amount here, and I can see that the total of this blanket is going to be my quantity here. You can indicate line discounts. So rather than directly updating my unit cost, I could have also chose to just put in a discount, and then that would come to my line amount, which is going to be my direct unit cost times my quantity. It would look at if there's any discounts, and it comes up with the total that I would be committing to in terms of dollars for that line. You've got your quantity to receive, what's been received, and what's been invoiced. So because this is a blanket purchase order, this is really your quantity to release. So when you want to actually place a firm PO because you want that product delivered to you, you will enter it into these two fields, and then you will make this an order, which we'll go over in another video there. But here you can see that already released off of this blanket, I have received 20 and 80. I can also add comments. So by leaving my type blank, I can drop down. These are called standard comments. So if I were to select, for example, just that number, it automatically defaults a description for me. So that's really nice, because if I have a comment that I'm adding on a regular basis, I don't have to key it in all the time. If I remove this here, I'll just delete the line. I can always leave this blank. And here I can just add a free form comment if I need to. Okay, so that's the basics of creating a blanket purchase order so that we can have a contract amount with our supplier for, again, better planning, better pricing.